Hi, in this Excel tutorial, we're going to go over how to make a new conditional format rule in Excel. This conditional formatting rule will be based on the value of another cell. So in the example on my screen, we have monthly store satisfaction scores for our stores. We want to make it easy to see which stores need additional training. These would be stores with average scores below 3. Excel already contains a number of preset conditional formats that can be applied at the click of a button. And for most everyday uses, they're perfect. The trouble is that they only apply to the value of the cell selected. And this is not too helpful when you need to format a cell based on another cell's value. Like in our example, we could easily highlight all cells with a value less than 3. But this doesn't help us with applying formatting to the name of the store based on the average of their monthly scores. This is a situation in which we'll want to create our own conditional formatting rule. This rule will need to look at the average scores for that store and format the store name based on the results of this formula. And by the way, if you find this tutorial helpful, don't forget to like the video and subscribe to the channel for even more tips. So in the Home tab, click on Conditional Formatting, and then click on New Rule. There are several rule types to choose from, but we're going to select Use a Formula to determine which cells to format. My active cell is currently cell B4 for store 1. To start, I'm going to create a new rule just for this cell. In our box here, we can type the formula that will determine the value to trigger our formatting. In this case, we're going to use the average formula. So we'll type equals average parentheses, and we're going to select cell C4 to N4, close our parentheses, and because we want to flag anything with an average value below 3, we'll say less than 3. I'll open this back up. And you'll want to get rid of the dollar signs. Otherwise, when you copy this formatting to other cells, they will all reference this first row, and we don't want that. So next, click Format to select the specific formatting that you'd like to see. Now for this example, I just want to make the font color red and bold. So we'll go to the Font tab and we'll select red and bold. You also have options to change the number formatting, the border type, or the fill based on the value of your formula result, but I only want the font formatting. So click OK. And if you're happy with what you see in the preview window, click OK again. Then to copy the formatting to other cells, select the cell you just formatted and simply use the Format Painter in the Home tab to copy the format to any other cells you desire. So I hope you enjoyed this tutorial on how to create a new conditional formatting rule in Microsoft Excel. If you did, please make sure to like the video and don't forget to subscribe to this channel. Thanks.